Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different, back with another video. Today I'm gonna teach y'all how to make this kind of cool future-esque type beat. You might like it. It's pretty dope. I mean, that's the name of this track, actually called Dope. And don't forget, I will give you the FLP along with all the other ones that I have done for videos, so you can get all those FLPs in one good place. And like I said, play around with whatever. Let's go ahead and listen to what I'm going to be showing you guys how to make it. Just walk you through the mythology and like what I did to pretty much make this beat. Let's do it. Now, it's actually a weird sounding beat, and it's got some weird kind of sound design and stuff to it that I kind of experimented with, especially with one of the sounds. But it doesn't have much going on, but yet, you know, I don't use a whole lot of sounds to get my beats because, I mean, I believe less is more. So let's start off with the first sound. The first sound is actually pretty cool. Like, it's actually Reactor 6, and I'm using a bundle that comes with Reactor called Rounds. Now, Rounds is basically a cool, like, subtractive FM synth that has a cool movement and motion effects to it, and that's how I suggest getting. It's really dope, and it does some really unique things. So I kind of played around with some of these sounds. Now, one thing about Rounds, you can actually have different, like, each different little section right here can have a different sound in it, and depending on, you know, which one you have. So you got 1, 2, 3, you got up to 8 different parts on the analog, which is subtractive synth, and the digital, which is FM synthesis. And you can have them doing different things. So you have subtractive synthesis over here, and you have FM synthesis, which is the digital. But I didn't go too much in detail about it because it would take a whole video to actually explain Rounds. But basically, I got two different synthesis going on, and it's morphing between the two different synthesis, as you can hear when I play this. So that's actually pretty cool. I made it to like a cool ARP with some crazy motion to it. Like I said, Rounds is a very unique plugin, and I don't know. If y'all would like to see a video about Rounds, I would definitely go over a video about it. I'll actually do a video of everything that come in Reactor if you guys so desire, because I don't mind doing that because I think Reactor is just a dope plugin anyway. But it's very powerful, but can be very confusing in the sense. So yeah, we'll leave that there. So yeah, I just made a little quick little ARP sound, and basically a pad ARP. As you can see, is a minor chord. I love my minor chord because they just sound dark and, you know, scary sound. A lot of trap beats I make are usually a minor, but, you know, it's up to you. It don't really matter, but I just use a C minor chords, and as you hear. And because of the Rounds, it actually sounds, I can play like one whole sustained note, and it sounds like it's, you know, got a bunch of movement going on. That's why I like it. So I suggest, you know, investing in different weirder type of synths to really get some cool sounds with. And then I actually added a parametric EQ2 to it and a gross beats on top of that to give it, to use the slow triplets. Because without slow triplets, it sound like this. Oh, let me, it'd be nice to play it, wouldn't it? So that slow triplets really give it its sound and its character. So next I use a choir, one of my favorite choirs. It's just a default choir from Ashley Contact, which, you know, you get the factory bundle. It's the choir O's. Usually I use the A's, but this time I use the O's because I think it went better with the sound. I use a parametric EQ2 to kind of focus in on the sound. So I kind of cut some of the highs and the lows, and I added a phaser to it. The reason I did this is because I want to turn this choir sound to like a pad-like sound. So by using the high-pass, low-pass filter and then putting on a flanger with it, a phaser, you get a cool pad-like sound. So like a choir pad, if you so desire. I think I made a video on choir pad. If I didn't, I would definitely make a note of you guys to show you how to get a cool choirly pad sound. So as you can hear, I'll actually play without the effects first so you can really hear what it sounded like before. See, very standard choir sound. And then when you add the effects on it, it turns to like a pad. And It still had that choir sound to it, but it sounded more like a pad than a choir. And then I just played some simple little notes, simple little chords, nothing spectacular. Just basically simple chords that anybody could do. I just kind of went up a note from what the root chord. I went up a note, and then went down a note with the other. So it's kind of a basic kind of chord progression. Nothing spectacular with it. Like I said, this is not a very progressive beat because it's trap. So you can be kind of simple with trap and get away with it, which is the good thing about trap, why it's so popular and why so many people make it. All right, next up is a Silent One patch, which that's just lead called Hard Lee Airbender, which is pretty cool. It's pretty dope. It's one of them like very high frequency pad. I mean, lead sounds you can hear. It's very weird. It sounded kind of like a video game laser sound. It's kind of a cool pad, but I wanted to add take away some of the highs. So what I did, I used a Pyramid EQ2 because EQ2 is like the best and simplest, EQ you can get, and everybody has it because FL Studio, of course. And then I added my RC24 because I love my RC24 because like one of the best reverbs I've used. I mean, it's probably my favorite, my go-to reverb in most situations. If not the only reverb I really use now and days, but it's pretty good because, like I said, Model is kind of a lexicon-ish type reverb, digital reverb. And then when I put the reverb and the EQ on there, you get this, it cuts the highs away, but it gives it a more open sound, as you can hear. Just gives it more space and more freedom to breathe because, I like to have a lot of reverb, a lot of openness to my stuff because it helps most of the sounds, like, go through and just blend and sound a lot better in the mix. And reverb can make a lot of sound, especially leads, sound really, really good. So always use reverb if you can. Sorry, no tomorrow, but who cares? Let's keep making the beat. All right, next up is a Tone Wheel Organ. I think this is actually the Vintage Organs in the Contact Library. It's really good. I really like this because it has like Tone Wheel Organs, which is really cool. And I mean, like, if you don't know a Tone Wheel Organ, it's like very popular. You got different type of organs, classical, jazz, default. I just use the default and I use the Tone Wheel Organ B3, and then I kind of mess around with my lower and upper manuals and then added some extra fast rotary speed and just played around with it a little bit to get kind of this trappy. Trappy organ sound like you be hearing like Zaytoven beats stuff. Yeah, I just like that sound. And I pretty much just copy and paste the choir sound. I just copy and paste that. So it got that cool little. And it's actually not in time with everything else, as you can hear. And that gives it kind of a. Here's a little flavor. I've learned that when you put stuff out of time and out of timing with other stuff, it actually sounds a lot better, in my opinion. Like, it gives it more of a bounce to it, a little bit more of a little knock to it, if I think so myself. So, but you can't really hear it in the mix because I don't want it to be too strong. Not that dang lead is super loud. But yeah, it's just got all of this stuff is actually off tempo and off beat and off. Like, only thing I think like as quantized completely is the snares because I want to keep that rhythm going, that at least. But everything else is kind of like off from one another, which is pretty cool because you're gonna see why, especially when I play the drums by itself. And matter of fact, drums. Let's get into the drums. Matter of fact, I layered three snares, so we got these two snares right here, that one, and then a clap. Little trappy clap. Got a little trap clap, right? And I did something weird with this, but I kind of did like a double hit all the way through. And I lowered the first one and the second one and alternated back and forth to give it kind of a unique little sound. Like, listen. Sound like a kind of a weird snapback delay type effect, but I did it manually through here. And I just sent everything through the EQ2 and just cut the lows, cut some of the highs, the focus in on it, make it more, aggressive sounding. Right here. Oh, and I use a transient. My bad. I cut some of the lows. I was on the wrong channel. I cut some of the lows because, you know, snares don't have lows. I use a transient master because, you know, why not add a little more attack and a little more snap to the snares? Because that's, you know, that's always nice to have, right? In an RC24 to give it just a little more room, a little space. Put it on the mix and only give about 10% of the mix. And kind of just did very light with the bass and mid frequencies because I didn't want too much reverb. I just wanted that little bit extra there just to help out and nudge it forward, if you understand what I'm saying. So here we go. You know, just give it a little more punch, a little bit more snap, a little more crackle to it. If you, you know, and one thing, like, I didn't really have to do all that. By layering it, it already sounded full, but, you know, why not go that extra mile? But sometimes you don't have to, but if you want to, going the extra mile will not hurt a thing. Next up is this cool little hi-hat. Very simple hi-hat. A lot of reverb in this beat. I just realized that. But I cut a lot of the highs and mids because, like, the hi-hats are really just kind of high frequency, upper mids and highs. And then just a little reverb to it, just a tad bit of reverb, about 20% of reverb, just to give a little bit of space. And I use my Alt-R trick to randomize the pitch and the velocity. So if you hold Alt-R, it'll bring up your randomizer, and you can randomize your pitch and your velocities to give it just a little bit more flavor, because why not? I mean, why not randomize to make it unpredictable? Next, to add this kind of, it's called a Samurai perk, but it's a weird sound, so I just thought that would be interesting to put at the beginning of everything. Of course, and then I got a cymbal. Little phaser cymbal. And I just added parametric EQ to and cut some of them lows because, like I said, once again, it's mostly high-frequency cymbals and hi-hats. The old perk triangle. The old trap perk. Oh, man. Ain't heard that. Ain't used that in a long time. I just had to use this time. Use my old-fashioned Blanca chant. From Street Fighter, of course, because who doesn't like Street Fighter? I know I do. And then I guess that's about it with all that. Then here go the drums. That's where it gets kind of interesting. Now, the drums and the 808s are off-tempo together. So first got this kind of grimy, kind of punchy drum kick. I cut some of the highs, a little bit of lows. Just enough to let, you know, to kind of focus it in, because if I take it off, you got make it look, it makes it a little bit more punchier, in my opinion. In the transient match to add a little bit more tack to it to kind of make it more punching in your face. And then with the 808s, is this cool little 808 here? Very distorted 808. It's like that's the sample by itself. Like, so that's one thing I learned, that if you find a good sample that sounds good, don't try to add to it. Just throw it in there. Just run with it, because sometimes samples are good enough by themselves. And then, like I said, I sidechained everything together. Like, I done did so much videos on sidechaining, so I sidechained my 808 to my kick drum, and I'll definitely make another video if y'all still curious about how to do that. But the one thing about the snare and the 808s that is unique, not snare and 808, the kick and the 808 that's unique to this beat is they're off. They're off tempo and they're off beat. So if you listen to it, they're like completely off. Like, it gets like, it's more towards the middle and the end is where the beat, the drums and the 808s get off, because that's just going to give it that bounce, especially when you add everything, like all the drum sounds. It really got a nice bounce to it. Like, I don't know, just the fact that it has that cool delay snare, the hi-hats that are randomized, the drums that are off from the 808s in certain parts, just makes that more, you know, I don't know, more live feeling, in my opinion. I don't know what you guys think. I think it sounds more live feeling. You know, I think you guys will agree. And then once you start bringing everything in there, you really get that future-esque trap sound that, you know, we all know. You know, throw some auto-tune on that and you got a hit. And then, like I said, that's pretty much it. Very simple, you know, four sounds, a bunch of drums, off-tempo stuff. Nicely done. don't forget, if you want this and you want to dissect it even further and see how I sequenced it, I'll definitely leave the FLP with you guys so you can go through and dissect it, change it up, add your own sounds, add to it, take away to it, make it your own, resell it, make your own money, you know, 100% royalty free. I do not mind doing that for you guys because you guys are great fans and great followers. Also, subscribe to my channel to help me out and build as well. And don't forget to thumb up this video and leave your comments below. And I'll keep doing this stuff if y'all want me to. I'm sorry that I haven't been making many videos. I've been very busy. I need to get back into making more. So with that being said, you know, it is what it is. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Once again, you know, if y'all want this, download the FLP. Check it out. Let me know. Thumb it up. Keep it on. You know who it is. It's your boy Slim, a.k.a. Miss Different. Not motivated by the money, but the like, comments, subscribes, and views. With that being said, hope you guys enjoyed it. Have a good one.